H looks exactly the same up there.
stressed out, okay? And I know that because this every girl in here has said this at least three times this week, right here. This is what a girl said. You go like this. I've literally been running around all day. And no, you fucking haven't, okay? First of all, you drove everywhere you went to, alright? I've literally been running around. I like to think about a girl all day, literally, just like, that's running around all day, literally, alright? That's actually the least stressful thing you can possibly do, if you think about that. You know who does that? A child does that, okay? A child can literally shit his pants and not be stressed out about that, alright? So you're not stressed out. Girls get stressed out, and it's good, though, man. Girls care, you know? Girls really care, and that's awesome. Because guys don't give a fuck. Girls care. Girls care, and then dudes are like, nah, it's going to be cool. Because girls care to a fault, you know? You really do. Like, alright, guys, you know when you're hanging out with your friends and there's like four of you or whatever, and then there's one girl that's hanging out with you and she's just around, and like one of you just starts picking on one of your other friends, right? Like, you'd be like, hey, dude, you're a fucking loser. Haha, fuck you, loser. And then the other dude might join in and be like, yeah, he's right. Fuck you. You're a loser. Ah, we both agree on that. And then the third dude will come and be like, yo, those two dudes are fucking right, loser. You suck, you know? And then the girl will be like, oh, but no, come on, he's not a loser. He's like, yo, I was joking, dude. You just made that shit real. Now I have to help him get a job. Like, what the... Never stressed out. I just don't care. I think it's actually a problem, like, for real. I think it is a problem. Like, I kind of feel like, I feel a little bit like I'm a sociopath or whatever. Like, I like this. Okay, here's one thing. Like, I watch every episode of Dexter. I love that show, okay? No, it's a good show. It's a real good show. I watch every episode, but during every episode, I'd watch that, and I would be like, yeah, that's the right move, Dexter. I would do that exactly. Like, that's wrong, you know? Whatever. But I didn't give a fuck. That's the whole point. Like, I don't care. I just, like, even when friends come up that you care about, right? That they'll come up to you and ask for advice about stuff, right? They'll just be like, hey, you know, I don't know what to do. I think maybe my girl's hanging out with another dude. What do I do? Like, I'll do the face where I'm like, oh, no. Yeah, poop comes out of my butthole sometimes. I don't care. I think that makes me a bad person. Like, for real. I don't care. I just don't care. Like, I got into an argument a little bit kind of recently. Like, you ever get in an argument and in the middle of the argument you're like, oh yeah, I don't give a fuck about this.
What the fuck I'm doing?
But by the way, that's always where I'm at, right?
By the way.
Like, if you ever get into a conversation and you get to the point where you go like this, what? No, I'm just gonna go like this. Yeah, you're probably right. Like, that's how much I give a fuck. That being said, okay, I've dated a lot of girls that love to argue, alright? Which probably secretly means that I like to argue, but we're not going to talk about that right now, okay? All I'm saying is that if you keep getting into the same problem, you're the problem. You know what I mean? But who cares about my therapist? So, the other day, this happened, okay? I was walking down the street. I was wearing my favorite bright orange shirt, okay? It's my favorite shirt. It's bright. It's orange. I wear it all the time. Right, as I'm walking down the street, I notice a girl that I used to date and hang out with walking my general direction, alright? And I immediately did what anybody in this room would have done given this circumstance. I go like this. Oh, fuck. Okay, because I remember our history, and we're definitely going to
argue,
alright?
You ain't heard.
Okay. But then I realize I'm wearing my favorite bright orange shirt. I'm an asshole because she's going to stop me trying to get away. And that's what's going to start the argument, right? She's going to be like, oh my God, where are you going? You're such an asshole. I see you. You're trying to avoid me. You never change. Or whatever. And then I'm going to have to fucking kill her like Dexter, right? Okay. You know what? Abort that plan. I'm just gonna do this kamikaze mission and see what the fuck goes down. Hope for the best, okay? So, as I'm walking down the street, I notice that the girl is walking with an older lady, okay? And they approach me, and the girl sees me and goes like this. Hey, Chris, oh my God! How are you? I've been seeing you so long! That's how she sounds in my head. So, then she refers to the older lady and she goes like this. This is my mom! Okay, I've never met this girl's mom before in my life, okay? I've never seen her, I don't know her. So just like in a cute way, I looked at the lady and I go like this. Oh, hey, what's up, mom? How are you? And the girl goes like this. Oh, no. Not your mom, my mom.
Oh, because you're charged.
All of a sudden, I thought that this woman was the one that I came out of, you know? Just like, whoa, no way, mom, get out of here. You know, I used to hang out with this girl. What a coincidence. I used to be inside both of you. Whatever, that's what I wanted to say, but then I would have had to kill them both like Dexter, right? So, I knew she was trying to push my button, so I just swallowed all of that, whatever I was going to do, get shitty, and I can't believe I heard these words come out of my mouth, but I looked at the lady and I go like this, oh, never mind, you're not her. Whatever. I kind of lost that one, you know what I mean? But also, I kind of won because I said I was planning not to argue and I achieved that goal, right? Okay. No, that's not the end of the story, okay? This girl was right there, and she wanted to fucking get her argument quoted. She took that shit to the next level, alright? She picked up my shirt, and she goes like this. Oh my God, what's the deal? You're wearing pink shirts now, huh? You didn't used to wear pink when we used to hang out. What changed? Now, if you remember, at the beginning of the story, the fucking shirt was orange, okay? But it was obviously orange, alright? It was the daytime when I ran into the girl. Nothing was blocking the shirt between her and I. And I know the shirt was orange because when I bought this shirt, I pointed to it. I said, hey, how much is that orange shirt? And the lady that worked there knew exactly what fucking shirt I was talking about, okay? Now, I'm pissed off at this point now because I know that she's trying to push my buttons, alright? But I didn't want to get shitty because I know that's what she wanted. So instead, I swallowed everything I wanted to say, and this is what came out of my mouth. I go like this. That's what you do sometimes instead of punching somebody in the face, right? Like, every energy you have that goes into knocking this motherfucker's head off swallows itself into your body and transforms itself into... So now I'm sitting there just going... And I get up and I say, no, this is orange. Like I'm a fucking Sesame Street character. Orange. This is near and this is far. Girl turned me into fucking Grover. But she didn't move her feet or blink her eyes and she goes like this. No, it's not. It's pink. Hey, now I'm so mad, right? Like, actually mad. Like, as mad as that Blanca lady was. Like, I felt that shit, you know? Like, that's how, like, I actually felt so mad I was going to shit myself. Like, there's two kinds of throwing up, alright? There's the kind of throwing up where you're like, yo, I don't really feel that good. I think I got a bug. I might throw up. And then you go, oh, here it comes. And you're like, now I feel much better. But then there's the other kind of throwing up where maybe you ate something and that shit was the bomb. Like, you loved it, right? And you're just going about your day and you're like, yo, that chicken was so good, man. And then you don't know you're throwing up until you already threw up. You know what I mean? Right? Like, it happens all of a sudden. You're like, yeah, that's true. Yeah! Yeah, no. Yeah! Like, I felt like I was going to scream vomit all over this family. But I caught that shit. My mouth hooked me up. They were in with the legs, and they fucking... I kept that shit in. And then I realized that that's probably how Russians get so mad. But through all of this, I was able to just eat these words out, and I looked at her and I said, you know what, I guess I just don't know the difference between pink and orange. And I did that because I didn't want to argue. And I didn't want to make shit weird in front of our mom. I guess the point of what I'm trying to say is, like, I'm not just trying to tell some stupid story about an orange shirt. I'm trying to make a larger point here, okay? And the point is like, if you want to argue, you kind of have to argue, you know? You gotta let that shit out. If you don't, it's bad for you. Like, you might end up resenting the person you're talking to or resenting yourself. Like, it's happened a few weeks ago, and I still think about it. Like, for real. Like, if I'm being honest, I thought about it every day. For real. Like, and I've, it's my favorite shirt. I told you, I've worn it since then. Every time I put it on, I'm like, fuck that bitch, it's orange. Like, it's so healthy. And the worst part about it is, she hasn't thought about it since the shit went down. You know? It's just all in a day shitty work for her, right? Like, there's no way she's in her apartment just like, it's pink, I don't give a fuck. Like, there's no way. It's weird how shit like that will piss you off, you know? But I feel like only an ex can make you that mad, you know? Like, only somebody that you've been intimate with can push your buttons like that, right? Like, anybody you've been in that moment with where you are, like, with them, like, naked, and that's you, you know? That's just you with no clothes on. You know what I mean? And her shit is out, you know, or in, and fucking... and you're on top of her. That's intimate shit. And you look in, you do eye contact. You fuck with eye contact. When you're doing it, I'll be like, look at me. Like, you... Like, it's so intimate. You'd be like, I could kill you, but I'm not. I would never do it. In fact, I'm going to do the opposite. This is love. Like, that's a moment that you share with that person. And later, if that person's like, ha-ha, fuck you, you'd be like, what about this shit? When I could have killed you and I didn't even do that. Outside of that, never what we do as men, the real reason we're doing it is to get in your pussy. That shit is crazy, dude. It's crazy, dude. Alright? It's harsh, but it's true, man. But here's the craziest part about that whole thing, alright? There's nothing in there. That means that all men want in life is nothing.
Whoa, what is happening? Are you playing Yeezy?
No, you are.
No, I'm not.
Bang. That makes you want to jump off a bridge. So all I'm saying is, girls, help us out. Make us feel less crazy as men. Just keep shit in there. You know what I mean? Worst prize ever. Some people don't think so. Eat dicks. Fuck that. Worst.
That's the three.
Okay.
That's the five.
Whoa, almost 4 a.m.
So that's the five. That's the five.
A lady, a grown lady, opens up her legs and a little mini version of her just rappels out. Like Tom Cruise in Mission Impossible. A baby just comes out like, okay? No, 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 no. can't figure that shit out. And he's just always like, no, no, no. Where are you going? You have to teach me stuff.
No, no.
Dad, come back here. I want to have a hamburger. I'm your possibility now. You come here. I can't show a kid to be a man, you know? A boy, show him how to be a man. I'm not manly at all. I don't do manly shit. Like, I cried recently. Like, you're never supposed to cry ever. As a dude, you're never supposed to cry. No matter what happens, it's supposed to bounce off your chest or whiz by you, and then 3 months later, you're supposed to be like, I don't even care. I'm a little man.
God, dude.
You're never supposed to cry. Maybe until, like, 1 minute right before you die, you got one tear just rolling. I definitely watch the whole movie, okay? Then, at the end of the movie, there's this really cute moment where the little kid in the movie looks up to Kazam, Shaquille O'Neal, and this is what he says.
I just want to remind you that, I consider you my friend.
Hey, I lost it, man. I didn't even cry how a man's supposed to cry, like, on his knees, in slow motion, holding his dying friend. Choppers blaze over his head. I cried. This is the noise that came out of my mouth. That's the most bitch noise any dude ever made in history. And I made it, okay? Tears didn't even stream down my face. They shot the fuck out. Like I was a Japanese cartoon or some shit. I was embarrassed and I was alone, okay? Do you know how embarrassed you have to be alone and embarrassed?
It's 3 p.m.
Yeah, it's just whenever you shine, you run off, and the shine, like, stays with you. I didn't need Invisible Woman just now. That was hype!